cut out the potatoes, chop them up, and put them in the pot. Okay, so now, the best way to hold a potato is in your hand, as like you're gonna throw it. The knife, you wanna hold your knife properly as a grip. Don't mind the nails, I'm a pro. I don't get cut or stabbed, because if I do, I'm gonna fall out. Anyway, so what you do, you wanna hold the potato and your thumb as a guide. So now you're gonna just guide it on, and you wanna have it at least under. I don't mind cutting half of the stuff off, but this is what we do. You have a good old roll here, okay? So just give me a second. Voila. The potato is cut. Now, what you want to do is cut downwards or sideways, however you want your potatoes to be cut in the shape, I mean. So now what you do, you cut down. Now remember, be careful. I don't like really sharp knives. So you always use your thumb as a guide. See? Boom. Never. Please, you're not sous chef or squash chef. You're not. Just listen, just chill with the knife, okay? So you have the two potatoes in half, but you want to keep them together. What you do is you want to cut sideways, and that's what gives you the arch. It gives you this type of shape. It's not no fancy shape, no chips or something. That's only one shape. I like my shape like this because when it cooks, it doesn't get too cooked and mashed potato. I don't like that. You want to at least have it fried a little bit. So you have that going on. I have to cut the rest of the potatoes. I don't know if you guys want to wait, so just hold on a second. Now all the potatoes is cut. So now, next step, we want to cut our bell pepper, our tomato, and our onion. The reason why we do this, we want to pre-cut everything before you start making the breakfast. Now, for onion, the best way for me is to cut it with the skin. And then bust it on down. So you don't have to peel the skin. I cut it. And that's what's gonna give you the dices. Boom. So you have that, put that to the side. We don't wanna cut it up yet. Now we have our bell pepper. Now some of this has been cold washed already. So don't be thinking that I'm just giving y'all some non-washed food. I know what y'all be thinking. Oh, this girl ain't washed that food yet. Some of them has been cold washed, so. Just chill. Leave the bad comments to yourself. Okay, so what you want to do with a bell pepper, some people like to cut it up or slice it and dice it. Doesn't matter. What I do is just go for it, you know? You want to slice as we go. We can. Either way it go, it's going to get cut. It's not really the real life, perfect life of a chef. I just do what I live. So I cut all around the sides, and then once you go in and cut, that's where you get your little dice back. Cool, right? Okay. So habanero pepper. I don't know if I'm saying it correctly, but this little guy ain't nothing to play with, people. Let's rinse it out. Listen, warning, caution sign, be very careful. This little man is extremely hot, like hot where you might want to go to the hospital, that's how hot it is, but it's very good for flavor. When you use this, please do not touch anything else. When you cut it open, do not touch your face. Do not touch anything on the counter. Rinse your damn hands. Sit this aside in some water so it can soak up. All the peppers can go somewhere else. But listen, be very cautious. You want to cut the top. You can poke a hole, cut the top. I don't even like to play. This little baby, I had an experience with this. I forgot it was on my hands, got in my eye. We're going to leave that for another part. So you had this open. I'm not ready to cut this shit. When I'm ready to cut this bad boy, it will be ready. Okay, so now we're going to go get, we're going to start with the potatoes and get those good cooking. Hold on, give me a second.